video provides a short overview of Leapfrog for new users to get up and running quickly. For more detailed introductory video tutorials, please check out the subsequent sessions. Once the license is active, Leapfrog will open to the Projects tab. The Projects tab is where you can create a new project or open an existing project. In addition to the two self-explanatory buttons, you can also use the thumbnails to open projects by simply clicking on them. Under the Recent Projects, Leapfrog will list your five most recently opened projects. Alternatively, you can direct the search to a particular folder in which you store your Leapfrog projects by simply clicking on the folder. All projects within a particular folder will appear underneath. In this video, I'm going to create a new project. I can give my project a name, and I can browse to where I would like to store that project. Once I've selected where I wish to save it, I can click OK, and Leapfrog will open in the scene view. There are four main parts of the screen. To the left is the project tree. In the center, the scene window. Below the scene window is the scene list. And in the lower right-hand corner is the properties panel. Other parts of the scene include the small main toolbar, the processing tasks list, and the Leapfrog Geo drop-down menu. The project tree is where we import our data, build our models, and create our output. The layout of the tree is designed to follow the workflow. You import the data in the top folders, you build the models in the middle folders, and then you create the output in the bottom folders. The functionality of the project tree can be discovered through a right click of the different folders. In this project, I will import four files: a mesh or surface representing the topography, a points file, a set of GIS lines, and a map. Each is imported into its respective folder. I will start by importing the topography mesh in the meshes folder by right-click Import Mesh. I can select the mesh and click Open. Leapfrog will present the standard cleanup mesh options. For the most part, you will simply leave the defaults and click OK. We can view this mesh by dragging it into the scene. Next, we will import a set of points by right-clicking the Points folder, Import Points, selecting the points of interest, Open, and then passing through the Import window. We can see right now that Leapfrog has correctly identified the easting, the northing, and the elevation points, so we can click Finish, and then drag those points into the scene to view. The points are difficult to see, so we can change the color here to something more contrasting, as well as changing the point size so that they are easier to view. Next, we can import the GIS data and the map into the GIS Data Maps and Photos folder. Again, simply right-click, and we will select Import Vector Data to grab our river's shapefile. We can click OK in this window, and we'll see that our rivers have been imported as well. If we would like our rivers to be a standard color, we can come down here and select Flat Color, and if we'd like them to be blue, we can select that as well. Lastly, we can import a map of the area. We can select the map, click Open, and we'll see this map has already been geo-referenced to the appropriate locations with the accompanying coordinates, so we can simply click Import. It's important to note during import that Leapfrog is a unitless program. Your project will adopt whatever units you import, like feet or meters, etc., so it is very important to be consistent. Numbers in Leapfrog, like resolution, measured distances, slicer thickness, and drill hole line radius, etc., use these units. As I just demonstrated, when an object is loaded in the scene, it also appears down here in what we call the scene list. And when you select an object in the scene list, the respective properties panel also appears for it. Now that we have all the data loaded, we will learn how to interact with it in the scene. Both the mouse and the keyboard allow control over the scene. I strongly recommend having a mouse while working in Leapfrog. While it is possible to exclusively use the keyboard or trackpad, a mouse makes the interaction with the scene much easier. First, to rotate the scene, you simply click and hold the left mouse button. You can zoom in and out by using the scroll wheel of the mouse. You can also pan around by either simultaneously clicking and holding the left and right mouse buttons down together, or by clicking the center scroll wheel if you have one. Lastly, you'll notice that by default, the center of rotation is around the center point of the data. But if you wanted to center around a specific point, you would simply click the middle mouse scroll wheel button, and you would now be rotating around that point. If your mouse does not have the middle mouse scroll wheel, you can also click and release the left and right mouse buttons simultaneously to rotate around a specific point of interest. Once you are done rotating around that point of interest, you can simply click the home key to restore your center of rotation as well as a default view. Other useful keyboard shortcuts are available in this look dropdown. The most commonly used one is the D key that allows you to look directly down onto your data. The remaining toolbar tools and the Leapfrog menu options will be covered in subsequent videos.